Good morning, children. Today we are going to start first chapter in 8th class mathematics. Before we start the main name, we just recall the about numbers which we learned in the previous classes. Do you know what are the basic numbers? The basic numbers in mathematics are from 0 to 9. These numbers are divided into natural numbers and whole numbers. So we already learned about the natural numbers. Natural numbers are called counting numbers. That we know that the set of numbers from 1 to infinity are called natural numbers. So these are represented by a letter N, and we can write this in the form of 1, 2, 3 and so on. The first or least natural number is 1, and the second number is 2, and the greatest number is infinity and does not exist. And we will go to the next set of numbers which are called whole numbers. The set of natural numbers including 0 are called whole numbers, which are represented by a letter W, and it can be written in the form of W equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So the least whole number is 0 and the greatest whole number is does not exist. So next we'll go to the next set of numbers, that is the combination of whole numbers with negative numbers. Such type of numbers are called integers. These are represented by a letter Z or I. So we can write this I equals to minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So whatever the numbers are there after 0, they are called positive numbers. Whatever there before 0, they are called negative numbers. And 0 is neither negative and nor positive. So the highest positive number is does not exist, and the least positive number is 1, highest negative number is minus 1 and so on. That does not exist, the least negative number. Then we will go to the next set of numbers. Before that I give an example. Raju went to a shop and bought set of 5 pens for 22 rupees. What is the cost of 1 pen? So that can be done by using a division. He paid 22 rupees for 5 pens. So what is the cost of 1 pen? That can be done by division. So you all know what do you mean by division. The up value is called a numerator and the down value is called a denominator. This is also called as a fraction. So these fractions are also called as rational numbers. Today we are going to learn about the rational numbers. That is your first chapter in 8th class. So I will tell the definition, exact definition of this. The set of numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q, where P, Q are integers and Q should not be equal to 0. So where P is a numerator and Q is a denominator here, and P, Q are integers, means you can take a positive number or negative number, and Q should not be 0. Why Q should not be 0? Because we cannot divide any number by 0. It is not defined. That's why we cannot divide. Q should not be 0. This rational numbers are represented by a letter Q, and we can write this one in the form of like this. Why the rational numbers are represented by Q? Why R? Why not R? Because the rational number word is starting with R, but they are representing the rational numbers in the form of Q. Why? Because the R letter is assigned for real numbers. That's why rational numbers are assigned for Q, because rational numbers are also called as quotient numbers. That's why it is given the letter Q. Why the word rational came here? Why the word rational came here for rational numbers? Because of the word ratio. In the rational numbers, the word ratio represents fraction. You all know that the ratios also can be written in the form of fractions. That's why the name has come rational numbers for this. So why the fractions are called rational numbers and rational numbers are called fractions, we are saying. Can you tell the difference between rational numbers and fractions? So in fractions, we take only the positive numbers as numerator, and in rational numbers, we can take both, that is negative and positive numbers. So how we write natural numbers, whole numbers and integers in the form of rational numbers? First we take the natural number 3. How this can be written in the form of a rational number? This can be written in the form of a rational number by writing 1 as a denominator. And this can be written in the form of 6/2. And this can be written in the form of 9/3 and so on. This is already equal to 3. So this is equivalent to 3. So like that we can write any natural number in the form of a rational number by writing 1 as a denominator. Next, how we write the whole numbers? Whole number 0, other than 0, all are natural numbers only. So whole number can be written in the form of a rational number by dividing any number to it. 0/3, 0/-7, that is equivalent to 0. So like that, how we write the integers? -1 can be written in the form of -1/1. -2 can be written in the form of -2/1, and so on. Therefore, we conclude that all natural numbers, whole numbers and integers can be written in the form of rational numbers by writing 1 as a denominator. Can we write the rational numbers into natural number, whole number and integer? We cannot. Only the natural number, whole number and integers can be written in the form of a rational number. So that we see in the form of a diagram. So first you take natural numbers. So starts from 1 to 3. Other than natural numbers, what is left over? That is 0. These are all whole numbers. And then afterwards you take integers. Other than 0, 1, 2, 3, we have negative numbers. And then we'll take the set of 1/2, -2/3, 0/7, and so on. So this is a diagram which represents the rational numbers. Okay? So these are integers and these are rational numbers. So once again I'll repeat the definition of a rational number, and also so these are all represented by Q only rational numbers. The set of numbers which can be written in the form of P/Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0, are called rational numbers, and that can be represented in the form of a letter Q. I said why it is represented by Q, because the rational numbers are also called as quotient numbers, and R is already assigned for real numbers. That's why it is represented as Q, and the rational why it came means because of the word ratio. So in the next class we are going to learn about the properties of rational numbers. Have a good day.